Hello, I'm Max Brantley with the Arkansas Times. It's Wednesday, August 27th. News in Arkansas today. A personal plea, stop. Please make it stop. And I'm talking about campaign 2014. Between the silly and the important stuff that gets ignored, I despair for our democracy. The flood of advertising has become such a noise that I don't think people pay much attention. But in the event you are, a couple of issues popped up in the last day or so pertaining to the U.S. Senate race, which a lot of people think could decide the balance of power in the United States Senate. Yesterday, Mark Pryor unveiled an ad that more or less linked Tom Cotton to Ebola. The ad had fair roots. It was about a vote that Tom Cotton cast against spending for emergencies such as pandemics. It could have an impact on reacting to an Ebola crisis. I think taking this into Ebola and pandering to some of the unfounded fears that exist about Ebola was perhaps a bridge too far. Pryor was roundly criticized for it. He defended it today at a news conference. Unfortunately for Pryor, this news, I think, tended to overshadow something far more significant and something absolutely having to do with a real live issue. An audio tape has emerged of a private meeting that the Koch billionaires had at a ritzy California resort in which they brought in favored politicians like Tom Cotton. This is the event he attended and skipped the Pink Tomato Festival and warned to some criticism. And they took turns praising each other, the Kochs and their people talking about what wonderful people Tom Cotton was, Tom Cotton saying how important the billionaire's money was to him and his race. The most significant thing that was said was is that Tim Phillips, the head of Americans for Prosperity, which is a Koch political organization, praised Tom Cotton for a 100% AFP voting record. Now, I'm sure there are people in Arkansas that share the AFP's views on things. And this is the kind of thing that elections ought to be about. If you do, vote for Tom Cotton. But these are things that are against environmental regulation. They're against taxation, progressive taxation on rich people. They're against social programs like food stamps, Medicare, and Medicaid as we know them. These are important bedrock issues, and you may agree with them, you may not agree with them. We ought to be paying some attention. And when a politician in Arkansas is described as 100% in the pocket of the Koch billionaires, it's time for people to take notice. In other news, Jermaine Taylor, the former world champion boxer, was arrested at his estate near Maumelle last night. It's called Bad Intentions after his ring nickname, and he's been charged with shooting a cousin in the leg. The details of this remain hazy. He was released this morning on a $25,000 bond. He was given permission to travel so that he can train in Florida and then go to Mississippi for another world title bout in October. Given the way boxing goes, probably having a felony rap on you probably will help attendance in the event, not discourage it. Chris Christie, the New Jersey governor, was in North Little Rock, Little Rock and Rogers today to help campaign for Asa Hutchinson. Chris Christie, really? Are you kidding me? Is he going to help us with our bridge traffic? We need him next year when they close down the Broadway Bridge. And how do you deal with the resulting traffic jams? He knows a little something about traffic jams. Arkansas got touted again in a national publication today as the poster child for Obamacare. No wonder. We confirmed yesterday, and you can find a story by David Ramsey on our blog about the fact that insurance rates on the health exchange and through the private option program are going down in Arkansas next year. Yes, it's working. This approach to insurance was a good idea, and it's helping a lot of people, and it's even producing some cost savings. There's going to be dislocations in private insurance, there's no doubt about it, but on the whole, the country's heading in the right direction on Obamacare. In time for this fall's election, that's another question. Stay tuned to our blog this afternoon if you happen to be in that tiny segment of the community that the Country Club neighborhood or the Trinity Episcopal Cathedral that have been split down the middle by this hot state representatives race between Democrat Clark Tucker and Republican Stacey Hurst. Stacey Hurst has made Clark Tucker's child's preschool assignment an issue in this race, a bad idea. I think Clark perhaps is understandably obsessed by it, but perhaps could move on to other things. In any event, we've got more details in this saga. The worst thing about it is a member of the Little Rock School Board who supports Stacey Hurst clearly has had a hand in disseminating political information. I don't happen to think that's a good use of an office of public trust. Finally, I take note on our blog today of some remarkable comments in oral arguments before the 7th U.S. Circuit Court of Appeals yesterday by Judge Richard Posner, who's a Ronald Reagan appointee, by the way. They were hearing one of the appeals of lawsuits that have struck down same-sex marriage bans in two states, one of them Wisconsin, to the argument that Wisconsin made that it was just traditional to ban marriage by gay people. The judge pointed out that it was also traditional for many years to ban marriages between people of different races, and that fell as it should have fallen. Posner also pointed out the problem that children face is living in families with unmarried couples and having to explain to other children why their parents might not be married while others are. He said it's a horrible thing and couldn't agree more. It's time for the Arkansas Supreme Court and the federal district judge in Little Rock to rule on cases here. I hope the Constitution does apply in Arkansas like it does in the United States. I'm Max Brantley. I'll be back tomorrow.